cope with the COVID-19 outbreak to help Singapore property owners ease financial burden pegged at 0.1% above the CPF ordinary account rate. The last 2 to 3 weeks has been extremely tough for all business owners and Singaporeans as we cope with the COVID-19 outbreak. Our government and healthcare workers are working relentlessly hard to contain the spread. While most of us are advised to work from home, businesses and retailers are affected badly from decreased footfalls and consumer spending. Hi, this is Jay, and welcome to another episode of JayChenPropertyMedia. Our audiences has been constantly engaging us since early last month to see what other methods are there to help Singapore property owners ease financial burden during this period. So for this episode, we want to share with all the viewers out there, what are the 3 ways that property owners can ease cash flow through 2020? So let's go. All right, guys, we're actually back at the studio. So what we want to share with you today is the Federal Reserve actually announced last month they want to cut interest rate by 100 basis points or 1%, which will bring borrowing rates close to zero. Singapore banks and MAS actually track the SIBOR closely as an indicator because we benchmark our borrowing rates back to the Fed. So property owners can actually explore refinancing and repricing within the same bank with higher interest to bring down their existing repayments. Let me give you an example. On the $1 million housing loan, the borrowers may be servicing at the existing 2.5% interest rate per annum. So at this present moment, most banks are actually offering housing loan interest at 1.7 to 1.8% range for completed properties. So there's actually a reduction of 0.8% per annum. That actually translates onto $8,000 a year savings on a $1 million home loan. MAS do allow homeowners to extend loan duration when they're applying for refinancing and repricing. Of course, that is subjected to the bank's TDSR and credit guidelines. So please speak to your bankers today and see if you can qualify. So for HDB owners, interest rate is currently at 2.6%, pegged at 0.1% above the CPF ordinary account rates. Now for HDB owners, you may want to take note, once your loan is officially tagged to the bank, you are not able to refinance the loan back to HDB. If you and your family do have plans to exit the HDB market within the 5 to 6 years mark, you may want to explore this path, as this will potentially ease more cash flow as part of our plans. So private property owners with capital gains accumulated over the years can actually explore tapping into their home equity loans for investments or business needs during these periods. So another example will be, the private property is bought at $800,000 and have since appreciated $400,000 to $1.2 million. So the outstanding loan is currently at $450,000 plus the CPF accrued interest used at $300,000. So taking $1.2 million as a bank valuation and 75% loan to value. So potentially, the property owner can unlock $150,000 from his home loan equity. So the third one will be the one we like the most, as it actually provides homeowners and borrowers to cushion their cash flow for up to 9 months. Just announced as part of the resilient budget by MAS, so property owners will be able to defer their principal or interest or both until 31st December 2020. So interest will be accrued on the principal portion for 9 months, while the interest on interest is waived. So borrowers will be able to extend their loan duration by up to 9 months or the deferment period. Any decision taken should exercise prudence into considerations and of course, subject to the bank's credit assessment. Alright, so we have actually come to the end of this episode sharing and we hope that these 3 methods shared today will help all Singapore property owners ease their cash flow and ride through this period. So, stay safe. Jay Chen Property Media signing off. See you soon. Financial burden during this financial crisis. To see if you can qualify. We should have capital gains. We hope.